Now, can we go to the word of the Lord?
Tunaenda enda kwa neno la Bwana.
Can we go straight away to the word? Last Sunday,
Jumapili iliyopita,
I know we were talking something about the grace.
Ninajua mlikuwa mnaongea kuhusu kitu
and what grace does in your life.
Na kile neema inatenda katika maisha yetu.
To be honest with you,
kwa wazi nanyi,
the Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
in the book of John chapter 1,
katika kitabu cha Yohana 1,
and that is the beginning of grace.
Na hapo ndipo mwanzo wa neema.
John chapter 1, I think verse number what now?
Mstari wangapi?
The grace, John 1:17.
Yohana 1:17.
Please give me. It says, everybody read with me, 1, 2, 3. For the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. Can't you remember, tell them, the law is given. Tell them, but grace comes.
But grace comes.
Now that is the difference between law and grace. The law was given, whether the people like it or not. It comes to those who want it.
Inakuja kwa wale wanaoitaka.
It comes to those who welcome it.
Inakuja kwa wale wanaoikaribisha.
It comes to those who are willing.
Inakuja kwa wale wanaotaka.
The law, you have no choice.
Sheria,
it is given.
Hauna chaguo,
but grace is different.
Lakini neema ni tofauti.
That is the difference.
Hiyo ndio tofauti.
The law was given, but grace came.
Sheria ililetwa, lakini neema.
Lift up your hand with me. Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
As I worship you.
As I worship.
As I serve you.
As I serve.
As I walk with you.
As I walk with you.
Release. Your abundance of grace.
Your abundance of.
Let your grace come.
Let your grace
upon my life.
Upon
my family.
Upon my family.
Upon my business.
Upon my business.
Upon my health.
Upon my health.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus.
Say, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
May you cause me.
May you cause me
to enjoy.
To enjoy
the abundance.
The abundance
of your grace.
Of your grace.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Grace came through Jesus Christ.
Neema ilikuja kupitia Yesu Kristo.
And that grace is still coming.
Na hiyo neema ingali
to as many as are willing to receive it.
Kwa wengi kama vile wanavyotamani kuipokea.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe. And let me tell you.
Na wacha nikwambie.
We need to understand.
Tunahitaji kuelewa.
We are in a dispensation of grace.
Tuko katika majira ya neema.
Now, I know we were taught on grace last Sunday and what grace can do in your life.
Ninajua mlifunzwa kuhusu neema Jumapili iliyopita na
vinavyo. But if you are to get the word grace as a synonym,
lakini kama unaweza chukua jina la neema liko limeandikwa kwenda chini,
G stands for gods.
G inasimamia Mungu.
R stands for riches.
R inasimamia utajiri.
A stands for available.
A inasimamia yapatikana.
C stands for Christ.
C inasimamia Kristo.
E stands for expense.
Inasimamia kwa
expense. Now that word is God's riches available at Christ's expense.
Utajiri.
Say again, God's riches available at Christ's expense. So when you are walking in the grace of God,
wakati unatembea katika neema ya Mungu inamaanisha,
you receive the riches of God.
Unapokea utajiri wa Mungu
through the expenses or expenditure of Christ. What Christ has already paid for.
Kupitia Yesu Kristo kile ambacho tayari amelipia, ametenda.
That is why we say grace is unmerited favor.
Ndio sababu huwa tunasema ya kwamba neema ni kibali ambacho hujakigaramia.
Grace is receiving what you don't deserve.
Neema ni kupokea kile ambacho haustahili.
Grace makes you stand out.
Neema inakusababisha uweze kuinuka kati ya
wengi. You are not the best.
Ingawa wewe sio wewe.
Though you are not qualified.
Ingawa wewe sio ambaye
umehitimu. Though you don't, you are not worthy.
Ingawa haustahili kupata.
It makes you rich yet you are supposed to be poor.
Inakufanya utajirike ingawa unataka kuwa maskini.
You have good health and live when you are supposed to die.
Inakufanya uwe na afya nzuri uishi wakati ulipaswa kufa.
It makes you a winner when you are supposed to be a loser.
Inakufanya uwe mshindi mahali ambapo ulipaswa kuwa wa kushindwa.
It makes you preferred where you are not as welcome.
Inakufanya uweze kuwa wa kuchaguliwa mahali ambapo
grace opens doors for you.
Neema inakufungulia milango.
You become the best when you are supposed to be the worst.
Unafanyika kile bora zaidi wakati ulikusudiwa kuwa mbaya.
May that grace operate in your life in Jesus mighty. Receive that grace, I say. Receive that grace by the anointing of this altar today. And as we come to the end of the month of October, the month of grace, according to me, may that grace operate for you in Jesus mighty. May the grace of God elevate you to the position where nobody thought you would go in Jesus' mighty holy name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Bwana
asifiwe.
But now today,
leo,
I want to go to another dimension of grace.
Ningependa kuelekea katika eneo lingine la neema.
How to tap into the grace that is in your prophet.
Jinsi ya kuweza kupata neema iliyo ndani ya nabii wako.
That will shake somebody's life from here, yo, and your life will never be the same.
Itatikisa maisha mtu hapa na maisha yako hayatabaki vile.
Let me start where it all begin.
Wacha nianze mahali ile.
Titus chapter 2 verse 11.
Tito 2 mstari wa 11.
That is where the teaching of grace begins.
Hapo ndipo mafundisho ya neema
inaanza. I have already given John 1:17. Jesus the grace and came through Jesus Christ. The Titus 2:11, the Bible says, read with me 1-3. For the grace
of God
that brings salvation has appeared to all men. Go to verse 12. Verse number 12, very fast, please. It teaches us to say no to ungodliness and worldly passions and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly life in this present age. The grace of God, number one, that it brings salvation.
Inaleta wokovu.
The grace and truth came through Jesus Christ so that all men may be saved.
Neema na ukweli ilikuja kupitia Yesu Kristo ili wanadamu wote waweze kuokolewa.
And if the grace of Jesus Christ or the grace of God that came through Jesus Christ it start to operate in your life.
Na neema ya Mungu iliyokuja kupitia Yesu Kristo ikianza kutenda kazi maishani mwako.
The first thing that you are supposed to do.
Jambo la kwanza unafaa kufanya
is to say yes to Jesus Christ.
Ni kusema ndio kwa Yesu.
Because the grace of God, number one, it is supposed to bring salvation.
Manake neema ya Mungu kitu cha kwanza inafaa ilete wokovu.
Hear me and hear me good.
Nisikize na unisikize.
Because many people today,
manake watu wengi leo,
they want the things of God.
Wanataka mambo ya Mungu.
But they don't want God.
Lakini hawataki Mungu.
They want to be rich. They want good car. They want a good house. They want good education. They want whatever. They want a good wife. They want a good, including there are people who come to church because they think now they want to get married and now they start spotting their are good girls in the praise team. There are good girls who come to church, and the only place you can get good girls to get married to is the church. You come here to look for good girls. The first thing you need to look for is to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior.
Kitu cha kwanza unafaa kutaka ukiingia hapa ni kumpokea Yesu kama Bwana na Mwokozi wa maisha yako.
I'm not the kind of a pastor who will want you to come here and you remain here a sinner for the rest of 5 years, 10 years. You go to church, you never got saved, but everybody welcomes you and you think you are a good.
Wewe unaenda kanisani watu wamekaribisha hujaokoka wewe unakaa tu unafikiria sasa uko sawa.
And you are used.
Na umezoea.
You say Bwana asifiwe like a born again. Unasema, you behave like a born again. You say everything like a born again. You even say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Like a born again.
Kama mtu ameokoka.
And you are not saved. You are wasting your time.
Unajua kama unapoteza muda.
When the grace of God comes upon you, the first thing that you're supposed to do is to bring salvation.
Wakati neema ya Mungu inakuja juu yako, kitu cha kwanza inafaa kuleta ni wokovu.
Like me or hate me.
Nipende ama unichukie.
But that is the truth.
Lakini huo ndio ukwe.
That is where it begins.
Hapo ndipo inapoanzia.
How many are with me? We were told Jesus is coming back.
Tumeambiwa Yesu anarudi tena.
I agree with that.
Ninakubaliana na.
But the Bible does not only say that.
Lakini Biblia isemagi.
It says.
Inasema.
Some of us.
Wengine wetu.
We are the ones who are going to go and meet him.
Sisi ndio tutakaoenda kumpata.
But to some of us we will still be alive by the time he comes.
Lakini wengine wetu tutakuwa hai.
So this thing happens in two ways.
Mambo haya yanatendeka katika njia.
Either you go.
Wewe uende
and meet him.
Na ukutane na yeye.
The grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. If you are living this life, don't deceive yourself.
Kama unaishi maisha haya usijidanganye.
The first thing you do, put your records straight with God.
Kitu cha kwanza unafanya, unaweka mambo yako na Mungu
sawa. We will live long.
Tutaishi maisha mazuri sawa, lakini
you better be prepared.
Afadhali ujiandae.
But he can come.
Ya kwamba anaweza kuja,
and I will not be ashamed.
Na hautaibika.
I will see God.
Nitamuona
Mungu. I will dwell with God forever.
Nitaishi na Mungu milele.
This is the hope we have.
Hili ndilo
tumaini. Whoever has this hope sanctify themselves.
Yeyote aliye na tumaini hili hujitakasa.
If he comes at midnight,
akija usiku,
if he comes in the morning,
akija asubuhi,
you better be found late.
Afadhali upatikane.
And the way to do that,
na njia ya kufanya hivyo,
is to receive Jesus as your Lord and your Savior.
Yesu kama Bwana na Mwokozi.
Don't think that you are just a young man who is enjoying life.
Wewe usifikiri kwamba ni kijana ambaye anafurahia maisha katika hii Nairobi.
Don't.
Usiwe.
Stop breathing as if you have the whole world in your pocket.
Wacha kupumua kana kwamba una dunia yote mfukoni.
Now turn to somebody, tell them this is compulsory.
This is compulsory.
You must receive Jesus Christ.
You must receive Jesus Christ.
Tell them you must be born again.
You must be born again.
Tell them live like a believer.
Live like a believer.
Tell them say no to sin.
Say no to sin.
For the grace of God.
For the grace of God.
That brings salvation.
That brings salvation.
Has appeared. To all men.
To all men.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus'
name. Amen and amen.
Amen.
And that is very important.
Hiyo ni muhimu mno.
That is the good gospel I have already preached.
Hiyo ni injili nzuri ambayo nimehubiri.
Amen.
Amen.
And before the end of this service, I will give you an opportunity to receive Jesus if you have not.
Kabla ya mwisho wa ibada nitakupa nafasi umpokee.
Whether you are young, whether you are old, whether you are a teenager,
wewe uwe kijana, barubaru ama mzee,
I tell you the truth.
Nakwambia ukweli.
You must be born.
Lazima uzaliwe mara ya pili.
Because the grace has appeared.
Maana neema imeonekana.
But now after we capture into the grace of salvation.
Baada ya kupokea neema ya wokovu.
Then we are enabled.
Tunawezeshwa.
To enter into the next level of God's grace.
Kuingia katika kiwango hicho kingine cha neema ya Mungu.
It says in Ephesians chapter 4 verse number 7.
Wa Efeso ni mstari wa 7.
This is now the second level.
Sasa ni kiwango cha pili.
Ephesians 4:7. Everyone read with me 1, 2, 3. But to each, come on, you need to be up, my brothers and sisters. 1, 2, 3.
But to each one of us,
grace has been given as Christ apportioned. In fact, it says to every one of us, it is given a measure of grace.
Kwa kila mmoja wetu tumepewa kipimo cha neema.
According to your gift.
Kulingana na vipawa vyako.
Amen.
Amen.
You have a measure of grace.
Na kipimo cha neema.
According to your gift.
Kulingana na kipawa chako.
When you come to Jesus Christ.
Unapokuja kwa Yesu.
Go to verse 8. That's what it says. Verse 8 of the same. Everybody read it. Wherefore says,
when he ascended
up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts to
men.
According to the gift God has given you,
kulingana na vipawa ambavyo Mungu amekupa,
he gives you grace,
anakupa neema,
to work alongside that gift, or the gift, or the grace to work the gift of God.
Itende kazi sabamba na hizo vipawa, ama neema itendeze kazi vipawa vya Mungu.
Amen.
Amen.
To those who are in praise and worship, there is enough grace to do praise and worship.
Kwa wale walio katika sifa na ibada, kuna neema ya kutosha ya kufanya.
For me, Pastor Gikwa, as a pastor, there is enough grace for me to do what I do.
Kuna neema ya kutosha ya kufanya vile afanyavyo.
That is why you cannot become me.
Ndio sababu hezi fanyika mchungaji.
Because you don't have the grace to do what I do.
Kuna neema ya kufanya vile anavyofanya.
But to you, there is enough grace.
Lakini kwako wewe, kuna neema ya
kutosha. And these levels of grace are different.
Na viwango hivi vya neema ni tofauti.
To people who are givers, God has raised them to be millionaires, to support the work of God. God will release grace to enable them to make wealth, grace to make money, so that they may support the work of God.
Kwa watu ambao ni wakupeana, Mungu amewapa neema ya kufanyika wa millionaire.
To people who serve,
watu wanaohudumu,
God will give them grace that is equivalent to the service they give in the house of God.
Gana na huduma wanayo kwa nyumba ya Bwana.
Now grace is given according to the gift.
Neema inapeanwa kulingana na kipawa.
By the way, did you know?
Je, wajua?
Paulo, he had different kind of graces.
Alikuwa na neema tofauti.
One of the grace that he had,
moja hapo ya neema aliyokuwa nayo,
was to live a celibate
life.
Ni kuishi maisha ya utauwa.
Yeah, to live a life of celibacy. He lived without a wife.
Aliishi bila mke.
He never married.
Hakuwa.
In fact,
ukweli,
Paul is saying,
Paulo anasema,
that I wish,
natamani,
in 1 Corinthians 7:7 and 8. Please give me that. 1 Corinthians 7:7 and 8. Verse 7, everyone read with me, 1, 2, 3. For I would that all men were even as myself, but every man has his proper gift of God, one after this manner, another after that. Go to verse 8, what does he say? I say, therefore, to the unmarried and widows, it is good for them they abide as I. But verse number 9 says, but if they cannot contain, let them marry, for it is better to marry than to burn with passion. Now, listen to me. Paul had a grace and a gift to live a celibate life. He never needed a wife. In fact, he never married. But, and he said, I wish that people would be like me. But, everyone has given according to the gift that he has.
So, if,
this is not a rule. If you cannot be able to contain the life of celibacy as a widow, or as an unmarried man, or as a widow, you are supposed to remarry, because that is the law. It is better to marry. Everyone of us, you need to operate within the gift, the grace of the gift that God has given. And that is important. Now let me go to the third level of grace. The first level of grace is that the grace of God that brings salvation have appeared to all men. Number two, every one of us should operate within the level of the grace God has given you according to the gift that is in your life. Amen.
Amen.
Now, this gift is not only on the fivefold ministry. Because when we talk of he gave gifts to men, people think only of the apostles, the prophets, the teachers, the evangelists, and the pastors. No. It is the gift for everything you do. If you are a teacher, if you are a housewife, if you are a business person, if you are a professional, if you are a student, there is the grace to go with that gift. May you receive the grace that is in proportion to the gift that God has given you today. Receive it, receive it, receive it. Because that is the grace. Once you connect with it, it will take you to the next level of your life. You will not struggle. God never created strugglers. He only created winners. May you be a winner by the grace that God has given you in Jesus' mighty name. Number three, very important. Number three, all of us,
zote,
we have an opportunity
to
tap directly into the grace that is in Jesus Christ,
who
is the custodian of all graces. 2 Corinthians chapter number 8, verse number, go, start from verse 7.
Anza mstari wa saba.
2 Corinthians chapter number 8, verse 7. Everybody, 1, 2, 3, please. But just as excel in everything, in faith, in speech, in knowledge, in complete earnestness, and in your love for us, see that you also excel in this grace of giving. Where do you tap the grace of giving? Go to verse 9. For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, so that through his poverty you might become rich. Now, listen. Inside Jesus Christ, there is all graces. And his desire is for us to excel in all those graces. And that is why, as you excel in this this grace of speech, this speech it is talking about preaching, it's about, it's like preaching proclamation,
kuhubiri, kutangaza,
in knowledge, in wisdom, as you excel in this grace, see also that you excel in this grace of giving. Giving yourself.
Kujitoa.
Yourself.
Wewe mwenyewe.
According to Romans 12, verse number 1. Giving your body as a living sacrifice.
Kutoa mwili wako kama dhabihu iliyo
hai. Giving yourself to the work of the ministry.
Kujitoa kwa sababu ya kazi ya huduma.
Giving your worship.
Kutoa.
Giving your life.
Kutoa maisha yako.
Amen.
Amen.
Come on. Bwana asifiwe.
Bwana asifiwe.
Giving your wealth, your
kutoa
money.
Utajiri wako na pesa
za. Paying your tithe, supporting the work of the ministry. You got to tap into that grace.
Lazima uweze kuchota, kupokea kutoka hiyo neema.
Where is that grace custod? Who is the custodian of that grace? The custodian of that grace is Jesus Christ himself.
Anayeweka hiyo neema ni Yesu Kristo mwenyewe.
Because the Bible says though he was rich,
Biblia inasema ingawa alikuwa tajiri,
yet he accepted to be poor.
Akakubali kuwa maskini.
He came to the earth, was born in a manger.
Akapeana duniani akazaliwa kwenye hori.
He was not born in Karen Hospital.
Hakuzaliwa Karen Hospital.
Or Nairobi Hospital.
Ama Nairobi Hospital.
Though he qualified to be born in Buckingham, Paris.
Ingawa alikuwa amehitimu kuzaliwa katika ikulu ya Buckingham.
Like the King of Kings.
Kama mfalme wa wafalme.
Amen.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Hallelujah.
He qualified to be driven on any motorcade, including the beast of Obama. And he was qualified even to be on Air Force One. Leave alone Air Force One. He was able to own Air Force 10.
Alikuwa na uwezo wa kumiliki Air Force 10.
But he came humbly.
Akawa kwa unyenyekevu, akaja kwa unyenyekevu.
He left his riches.
Akaacha utajiri
wake. Became poor. So that he may exchange.
Ili aweze kubadilishana.
Bwana asifiwe.
Bwana asifiwe.
You know he became so, he came with that kind of a style. Not with none of us.
Unajua kama angekuja na
ugeangalia bali tu sema hey.
Huyu hatutoboi.
Uliona watu vile waliangalia Obama alipokuja Kenya?
Eh.
Ndege ina ndege badala ienda hivi, inaenda hivi.
Ndege za wapi hizi?
Wewe
acha waone bi.
Wewe watu washangaa. Wanajua hapo hawezi karibia.
Hapo hawezi.
Kutoka JKIA Nairobi yote hakuna magari.
Baba na magari zote ziko wapi? Baka huko majirani.
Wale wametoka baka wale wako hivi.
Eh.
Mfarume ameingia Kenya. Hiyo ndio mlijua kuna wafarume. Wangapi mko hapa Bwana asifiwe.
Asifiwe.
Is this good? Bwana asifiwe.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Yesu.
He was rich.
Alikuwa tajiri.
But he never came to show a demonstration of riches.
Lakini hakuja kuonyesha utajiri wake.
Eh?
Mhm.
Unajua Obama aliamua kabla niache hiyo kiti nitaingia Kenya.
Mhm.
Unajua alikuwa nikiingia huko naenda kogaro wanaona kijana na beba gunia ya viazi ya shosho yake.
Viazi.
Nitaingia hiyo Kenya kabla nitoke hiyo kiti. Hawata sai sahau. Na kweli aliingia. Mara moja na ya kutosha. I'm telling you. Sasa anatoka kwa kiti. Hiyo sasa hawezi rudi hivyo alikuwa. Yesu atarudi zaidi sasa akiwa mfalme wa. Yesu aliingia kama Jesus came as a poor. Now he will come as the King of Kings and
Yesu.
As, kama unafikiria uliona kitu wakati huo bado hujaona chochote.
Hujaona chochote.
I'm telling you bado hujaona kitu.
Hallelujah.
Biblia inasema majeshi yatasimama kwa
hewani.
Na tarubeta zitakuwa zinapigwa kutoka mbinguni zikiangalia chini. Kwanza ni wale watakuwa kaburini. Makaburi itapasuka. Watu watainuka kwa makaburi.
Hallelujah.
Watakuja na kila. Watashuka na matumbo safi. Watasema hakuna kazi tumekuwa tukifanya ni kunona peke yake. Huko hakuna kazi tumekuwa kazi yetu ni kukula na kunona. Watatokelezea. Wewe! Bwana asifiwe. Na wale watakuwa hai watabadilishwa mwili.
Yeah.
Watavalishwa mwili mwingine ya roho. Kisha safari itaanza. Twende tukutane na yeye. All of a sudden gravity itabadilika.
Yeah.
Sheria ya gravity ilikuwa inavuta chini nini?
Inabadilishwa.
Itairusha vitu juu.
Yeah.
Lakini wale walio na dhambi hawatapaa juu.
Hawata.
Alafu hewani hapo ndipo harusi itafungwa. Kwa hewa. Woo! Mnasemaga mahewa. Sasa siku hiyo haitakuwa mahewa, ni kufunga harusi hewani.
Hewani yenyewe.
You have not seen anything yet.
Hakuna harusi ushawa.
Wewe dumu kwa huyu Yesu.
Kwa Yesu.
Do you believe the word of God is true?
Yes, it is true.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe. I believe it with all my heart.
Naamini na moyo wangu wote.
Harusi itafanywa kwa hewa. Ishafanywa. Then itateremkwa. Lakini kabla kuteremkwe, kutaendwa honeymoon. Honeymoon itakuwa binguni. Unajua itakaa muda gani? 1000 years. Honeymoon peke yake. Hiyo ni rihaso ya eternity. Saa hiyo hapa duniani kutakuwa na moto na sarva. Shetani atakuwa hapa na wale ambao watakuwa wanateseka. Hapa duniani kutakuwa kubaya.
Mateso.
That is called the great tribulation. Mimi siamini tribulation itakuta kanisa hapa. Mimi naamini tutakuwa tumeenda honeymoon. Hiyo ndio doctrine naamini. Wewe yaamini ya kwamba mtateseka hapa. Mimi siko hapo. Mimi sitakuwa hapo. Hii vitu nimejifundisha kiasi na nimeomba. Naambia Bwana nisaidie kuelewa haya maneno ili nikae sawa sawa. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, acha tuachane na hiyo. Itaharibu ile message. Message ilikuwa nini?
The grace.
The grace. Tulikuwa grace, eh?
Yeah.
Turudi kwa grace.
Hallelujah.
Tari anaiba turudi kwa grace.
Turudi
kwa grace. Bwana sifiwe.
Hallelujah.
Pigia Bwana shangwe. Pigia Bwana shangwe. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Ribo shepereketa. Masato robo shepereketa.
Hallelujah.
As you grow in our grace, see that you also excel in this grace.
Oneni kwamba munafauru pia katika neema hii.
For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, that you through his poverty may become rich.
Manake mnajua kwa neema ya Mungu Yesu Kristo, ingawa alikuwa tajiri, alifanyika maskini ili wewe kupitia neema ufanyike tajiri.
Now turn to somebody there, tell them I decree.
I declare
through the grace,
through the grace
of riches,
and
wealth, that was in Jesus. I tap into the same. Therefore, I am rich.
And not poor.
Ebuge ukia mtu mwambie, you are looking at a rich person.
You are looking at a rich person.
Ebu simameni ni mwaonyeshe kidogo. Bwana asifiwe. Ebu simama kidogo. Bwana asifiwe. Simama kidogo tuone. Kama unampenda, simama kidogo. Now, with that attitude, just turn to somebody, tell them, Right now, you are looking at a rich person.
You are looking at a rich person.
Tell them,
I am rich.
Through the riches of Christ. Tell them, I am rich.
In my health.
In my mind.
In wisdom. In knowledge.
In understanding. In intelligence.
I am rich.
Financially. Materially. Tell them wealth
is my portion.
Tell them gold. Tell them gold. Answers to me. At the click of a finger. Tell them silver.
I will walk on them.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Tell them Jesus.
The best class belong to me. Tell them the best houses.
The best estates.
Belong to me. Tell them the best flights in the world.
They belong to me.
I can ride them anytime. Through the grace. Of the riches of Christ.
Sasa.
Mwambie sasa.
Alafu
mwambie kwa hivyo.
Kwa hivyo.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe. How many rich people do I have here through the riches of his grace? In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
May this truth break in your heart like a river.
Ukweli ukavunje katika moyo wako kama mto.
Young men, young ladies who are here, may this truth break in your heart like a river in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Katika moyo wako kama vile mto unavyovunja kingo zake.
And suddenly your life will start to take a new turn.
Na maisha yako yataanza kupata mwelekeo mpya.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Once again, turn to somebody. May you grow in this grace.
May you grow in this grace.
The grace of giving.
The grace of giving.
To tap. Tell them to tap.
Into the grace.
Of riches.
And wealth.
That is in Christ. Now listen as I speak.
Excuse me.
That is the key.
Hiyo ndio funguo.
That is the key.
Hiyo ndio funguo.
To tap.
Ya kufungua,
to tap,
ya kuchota,
to tap,
kupata,
into the grace of giving that is of riches that is in Christ. The key to tapping that grace is by giving.
Njia ya kupokea kutoka kwa ile neema ni kupitia kutoa.
It will remain there.
Itakaa.
Jesus was rich.
Yesu alikuwa tajiri.
But you will never experience those riches.
Lakini hautapata ule utajiri.
Until you tap.
Baka uweze kuchota kupokea.
You tap.
Upokee.
How do you tap?
Wewe wapokeaje?
You tap through giving.
Unaipokea kupitia kutoa.
Let me show you how it works.
Wacha nikuonyeshe vile inafanya kazi.
It is like this electric. It is like this light.
Ni kama hii huu mwangaza.
This lights,
mwangaza huu,
they are there.
Mataa haya mwangaza huko pale.
But they cannot light.
Lakini haiwezi
until
mpaka.
I say until
mpaka.
Until what?
Mpaka nini?
Until what?
Mpaka nini?
Until what?
You tap.
Until I go to the switch.
Niende kwenye switch
and put it on.
Na iwe
niweke. It is there. It is there.
Iko.
Don't tell me it is not there.
Usiniambie mwangaza hauko.
Electricity is there. The light is already there.
Sasa stima iko. Hiyo
kitu kinaonyesha tayari kuna mwangaza.
Kuna nuru, kuna.
Lakini unaweza osea hapa.
Kuna stima.
Unaweza osea kwa giza hapa.
As long as you are not willing to do what?
To tap,
to put on the switch. That is how it works.
Hivyo ndivyo inafanya kazi.
Jesus for yes, your he was rich.
Alikuwa tajiri.
But for your sake he became poor so that through his poverty through your poverty you may become rich.
Ili kupitia umaskini
but that will never happen. That will never happen.
Haitafanyika.
I say that will never happen.
Amen.
Until somebody do what? You tap.
Yes.
Ni wewe uchukue miguu yako kama mimi sasa na nielekee moja unyo kwa unyo unyo mwendo wa haste. Haste bila nini haraka bila kuumwa na tumbo bila kigeugeu bila kusambaratikishwa na chochote niende kisha nikifika pale nisisimame niamue nitafanya nini nitawasha
yes
iwake ya kwanza kisha niwashe nyingine nifanye nini iwake yote. May that be your story in Jesus' name.
Yes,
may that be your story in Jesus' name.
Amen.
May you tap into the grace of riches that is in Jesus Christ today. In the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Somebody say yes.
Yes.
Somebody say I choose
to tap
into the grace
of riches
that is in Christ Jesus. Amen and amen.
Hallelujah.
How do you tap into it? By giving. How do you tap into it?
By giving.
How do you tap into it?
By giving.
In Jesus' name.
Yes.
Amen and amen. God bless you. You may be
seated.
But now I go to the third level and level. The last. This is now the most important. This is now one of the most important. Because Jesus taught and said, you cannot connect with your Father in heaven who you don't see.
Wezi jiunganisha na baba yako wa binguni ambaye haumuoni.
If you cannot connect with your brother here on earth who you can see.
Kama hawezi jiunganisha na ndugu yako hapa duniani mwenye unaweza ona.
Here on earth
hapa duniani.
Jesus when he said that he gave gifts to men.
Yesu alipopaa alipeana vipao kwa wanadamu.
Some he gave prophets, apostles,
manabii.
For what? And that is what is for the edification, for the equipping of the church.
Kwa sababu ya ujenzi wa kanisa.
That is what it says in the book of Ephesians chapter 4. Verse number 11. Please give me verse Ephesians 4, 11, 12. And then I'm about to finish. Read with me 1, 2, 3. But he who gave some
to be,
but it was he who gave some to be apostles, some to be prophets, to be evangelists, some to be pastors and teachers, verse number 12, to prepare God's people for works of service, so that the body of Christ may be built. Okay, come to Philippians chapter 1.
Wa Filipi moja.
Philippians chapter 1, verse number 1, please. Let's drop there very fast to verse 7. Paul, everybody, Paul and Timothy, servants of Jesus Christ, to all the saints in Christ Jesus at Philippi, together with the overseers and deacons, verse number 2. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ, verse number 3. I thank my God every time I remember you, verse number 4. In all my prayers for all of you, I always pray with joy because of your partnership
in the
gospel from the first day until now. Verse number 6. Being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Jesus Christ. Verse number 7. It is right for me to feel this way about all of you, since I have you in my heart. For whether I am in chains or defending and confirming the gospel, all of you share in God's grace with me. Now, listen what happens. When Paul started preaching the gospel, the church of
Philippi,
they stood out among other churches. Among those who were in the Corinth, the Romans, Colossae, those who were in Thessalonica, and they received partnership of Paul in the gospel. And they would gather together, they give their gift to send to where Paul is preaching. When he is in Colossae, they would gather, they raise a man, they send him to Colossae. If he is in Thessalonica, they would gather, they give somebody to take to
Thessalonica.
Because they were partners. They were partners.
Walikuwa washirika
pamoja naye. Nobody else.
Hakuna mwingine.
Among other churches did that.
Ya makanisa mengine waliofanya hivyo.
Of the churches of Macedonia.
Ama makanisa la Macedonia.
The churches that came to be classified as the Asia Minor and churches.
Makanisa ya
Asia Minor. These were the most rich.
Haya ndio yalikuwa matajiri.
It is recorded in the Bible how they turned their poverty into riches.
Imenakiriwa katika Biblia vile walivyobadilisha umaskini wao.
They become great millionaires in this church.
Wakawa mamilionea wakuu.
In fact, when you go to chapter 4,
ukienda sura ya 4,
verse number 15,
mstari wa 15,
verse 15, Philippians 4.
In 15.
Philippians 4, 15, please. Read with me, 1, 2, 3. Moreover, as you Philippians know, in the early days of your acquaintance with the gospel, when I set out my Macedonia, not one church shared with me in the matter of giving and receiving, except verse number 16. Come, verse 16, please. If for even when I was in Thessalonica, you sent me aid again and again when I was in need. Go for 17. Not that I am looking for a gift, but I am looking for what may be credited to your account. Go to verse 18. I have received full payment and even more. I am amply now that I have received from Epaphroditus the gifts you sent. They are a fragrance offering, an acceptable sacrifice, pleasing to God. Verse 19, you do not tunapeda. And my God will meet or supply all your need according to his glorious riches in Christ Jesus. But you don't follow to know where it is coming from. Philippian churches,
makanisa ya Philippi,
they would gather and give their offerings.
Wangekutana wanatoa sadaka zao.
And they would decide them where Paul is preaching.
Wanatuma mahali Paul anahubiri.
And on this specific occasion,
katika tukio hili,
Paul is in Thessalonica.
Paulo yuko Thessalonica.
And they have already gathered their gift.
Tayari wamekusanya vitu.
And they have sent Epaphroditus to take.
Tuma Epaphroditus.
And so he is commending the man, saying, you Philippian, no. In the beginning of the gospel, no church shared with me except you. Time and again, you gathered your gift and sent to me. No wonder, now that I have received this gift, it is not because I am in need, but I am happy because God will accredit it back to your account. You are a partner with me in the gospel. And now, go back to chapter 1,
sura ya kwanza,
where he speaks in verse number 7.
Mstari wa saba.
Go back to 1:7. This is what happened. It is right. Everybody, 1, 2, 3. It is right for me to feel this way about all of you, since I have you in my heart, for whether I am in chains or defending and confirming the gospel. All of you share in God's grace. What happened? Ethiopian churches, by their partnership to the ministry of Paul, they partnered in his grace. Nobody in the whole Bible operated in greater grace than Paul. In fact, this is what he said at the end of his preaching. If you would give me 1 Corinthians 15:10. He says, but the grace, by the grace, everybody, but by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace to me was not without effect. No, I worked harder than all of them, yet not I, but the grace of God that was within me. In fact, this is what he says in one of the translations in that scripture. He says this, but whatever I am now, it is because God poured his special grace on me.
Mungu alimwaga neema yake speciali juu yangu.
And that special grace that was on me,
hiyo neema speciali iliyokuwa juu yangu,
it produced results.
Ikaweza kuleta matokeo.
It produced results.
Ikaleta matokeo.
It produced results.
Ikaleta
it produced results.
Ikaleta matokeo.
It produced results.
Ikaleta matokeo.
It produced results.
Ikaleta matokeo.
May the grace of God in your life produce result. Let there be results of the grace of God in your health, in your family, in your marriage, in the life of your children, in your business, in your finances. Let there be results. Let there be results.
We are not just here to talk of grace without result.
Lazima matukio yaonekane. Lazima matukio yaonekane. Bwana sifiwe.
Hallelujah.
Now listen.
The Philippian people,
wa Filipi,
by partnering with him,
kwa kushiriki pamoja na Paulo,
they tapped,
wakaweza kuchota,
into the grace of God,
kutoka kwa neema ya Mungu,
that was in the life of Paul,
iliyokuwa katika maisha ya Paulo.
And that is how it works.
Na hivyo ndivyo inatenda kazi.
When you learn to tap into the grace of God that is in your prophet.
Wakati umejifundisha kuchota kutoka kwa neema ya Mungu iliyo ndani ya nabii wako.
It means what God is doing with him, he will do with you.
Inamaanisha kila Mungu anatenda ndani yake, atatenda ndani yako.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
It means what God is doing for him, because you have tapped into the grace that is in his life, God will also do it for you.
Kila Mungu anatenda juu ya maisha yake, kwa sababu umeweza kujiunganisha na hiyo neema yake, atakitenda pia Mungu juu yako.
What God is doing in the life of his, the children of his servants, because you have tapped into the grace that is in his life, God will also do in the life of your children.
Kile ambacho anatenda juu ya maisha ya watoto wake, kwa sababu umeunganisha maisha yako na maisha ya mtumishi wa Mungu na neema hiyo, atatenda katika maisha ya watoto wake.
Learning to tap into the grace of God that is operating in your prophet.
Kujifundisha kuweza kuchota neema ya Mungu inayotenda kazi katika nabii wako.
This is the third, fourth level of grace, and it is very practical, and it's the one of that is very easy to tap.
Ni kiwango cha nne cha neema na kinatendeza kazi na ni rahisi kuchota.
Are you hearing me?
Hallelujah.
How many are with me and turn our banners if you? Blessed be the holy name of the Lord.
Oh, yes.
At a given time, you know, let me tell you the truth.
Wacha
God has a way of dealing with his servants.
Mungu ana njia ya kushughulikia watumishi wake.
You remember Elijah?
Unakumbuka Elia?
Elijah, he said, there is not going to be famine 3.5 years.
Anasema kutakuwa na kiangazi miaka 3.5.
What happens that evening?
Jioni
there is no, everybody is has no food within 1 year.
Kila mtu hana chakula mwaka mmoja sasa.
What of Elijah?
Elijah,
he is eating meat.
Anakula nyama.
and drinking water.
Na anakunywa maji.
And he is eating well, bread.
Na anakula mkate.
And drinking water.
Na anakunywa maji.
And God has told him where to stay.
Na Mungu amemwambia mahali atakaa.
Shortly after that, he takes him to the widow of Sarefath.
Akampeleka kwa mama.
He tells the woman, make some bread. Bake some bread.
Mkate.
Give me. For thus says the Lord. Once you do that, you will not lack.
Unapofanya hivyo hutakosa.
What happened? The woman bakes the bread.
Mama anatengeneza
mkate to the man of God.
Anapelekea mtumishi wa Mungu.
What happened?
Nini kinafanyika?
For the next 2 years.
Miaka miwili.
After Elijah took that bread.
Baada ya Elia kukula ule mkate.
The woman never lacked the food.
Mama hakukosa chakula.
Her son never lacked food. In fact, she brought her mother.
Alileta majirani na watu wao
wakula. They were eating in her house.
Wakulage kwa nyumba
yake. What happened to the woman?
Nini ilifanyika huyo mama?
She tapped into the grace of God that was in Elijah.
Alijiunganisha na neema ya Mungu iliyokuwa ndani ya Elia.
Elijah was the superstar in that story.
Elia.
He did not die. It doesn't matter if the famine could have gone for 10 years. Elijah would not have died because he was the superstar.
Elia ndiye alikuwa pingwa katika ile historia. Yeye hangekufa hata kama kiangazi kingeendelea miaka 10.
And anybody who connected
yote mwenye alijiunganisha na yeye
with the grace of God.
Neema ya
that was an Elijah.
Ilikuwa ndani ya Elia.
They was not so going, they were also not going to go hungry.
Hata naye hangepata njaa.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
They could not go hungry.
Hangepata njaa.
Because
they have tapped in.
Kwa sababu amejiunganisha
with the grace of
Elijah. Amechota kutoka kwa neema ya Elia.
How many are hearing? Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe. That is what happened to the Shunammite woman.
Hivyo ndivyo ilifanyika kwa yule mwanamke Mshunami.
She told her husband.
Akaambia mume wake.
I see this man is a prophet.
Naona huyu mtu ni nabii.
Let us tap into the grace.
Acha tuweze kuchota hii neema.
That is in him.
Hii neema iliyo ndani yake.
By making him a bed and a table.
Tutengeneze kanyumba juu, kitanda na taa.
Within a short time.
Dakika chache.
They had it tapped.
Walikuwa wamejiunganisha. Walikuwa wamechota.
So the blessings of Elisha.
Baraka za Elisha.
Became their blessing.
Zikafanyika.
The miracles of Elisha. Became their miracles.
Come you Jesus.
The life of Elisha.
Maisha ya Elisha.
Became their life.
Amen.
What God was doing for Elisha.
Kile Mungu alikuwa anafanya
kwa Elisha. He did it for them.
Akafanya kwao.
But
kweli
he got a miracle child.
Wakapata mtoto wa mguji.
And after the child died,
baada mtoto kufa,
Elisha had to pray for
Elisha,
the baby to come back to life.
Angemwambia yule mtoto arudi hai.
Why?
Kwa nini?
Because they had tapped
kwa sababu
into the grace
wamejiunganisha na
that was in this man of God. You can learn to tap into the grace that is in your prophet.
Unaweza jifundisha kuchota neema iliyo ndani ya nabii wako.
You are not hearing me. You can learn to tap
yes.
to the grace God has given you as his servant that is speaking in your
life. Amen.
Yes.
How many are with me until now?
Hallelujah.
And that is what I do myself.
Even if mimi ufanya.
I realize the servants of God God has given me.
Nagundua watumishi wa Mungu ambao Bwana
I realize the grace that is working in their life.
Neema inayotenda juu ya maisha yao.
And I tap into that grace.
Ninaweza kuchota kutoka kwa
hiyo. I tap into that grace.
Nachota kutoka kwa hiyo neema.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
When Bishop Mark built a house in Nakuru.
Wakati Askofu Mark alijenga nyumba Nakuru.
I mobilized our people in Kinamba.
Tulimobilize.
I told them we are going to go to Bishop.
Tukaenda kwa Askofu.
And we went to visit him. We had a sacrifice.
Tukawa
na I carried my own and the lot of the church.
Nikabeba yangu na ya kanisa.
We went to his new home.
Tukaenda kwa nyumba yake.
We told him Bishop we have come to see you.
Tukamwambia Askofu tumekuja kukuona.
And he blessed us.
Akatubariki.
Shortly after that.
Kifupi kutoka
I was able to start building my own.
Nikaweza kujenga nyumba yangu.
Are you hearing?
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
I do that every time.
Nafanya hivyo mara nyingi.
Because I know the prophets that God has given me.
Manake najua manabii ambao Mungu amenipa.
Bwana asifiwe.
Hallelujah.
Bishop Mark was buying a V8. Bishop Kichana was buying a V8 just a few months ago.
Bishop Kichana alikuwa ananunua V8 miezi michache imepita.
And he told us.
Akatuambia.
I want my friends to stand with me.
Nataka marafiki zangu wasimame nami.
That is the kind of a thing I do very fast.
Sasa hiyo ndio aina ya vitu ambavyo mimi
ufanya. I told my wife, we got a sacrifice. We sent it to our bishop.
Nikamwambia mke wangu acha tutafanye.
What did we do by that?
Tume.
We tapped into the grace.
Kutoka kwa neema.
Amen.
So if you see me driving a different car today, I have already tapped into the grace that is operating in the prophets who God has given me.
Ukiona nikiendesha gari tofauti leo, nimechota kutoka kwa neema ya.
Some of you cannot understand how these things work.
Wengine hamwezi elewa mambo haya yanatenda kazi.
Because spiritual things are spiritually discerned.
Ya kiroho yanapambanuliwa kiroho.
You got to tap into that grace. Very fast.
Kwa hiyo neema.
Because you become a partaker of the same level.
Unafanyika mshiriki wa kiwango hicho.
When you see God blessing the marriage of his servant, tap into that grace of good marriage.
Unapoona Mungu akibariki ndoa ya mtumishi wa Mungu, chota kutoka kwa hiyo.
Can I tell you the truth? Let me tell you the truth.
Nikwambie ukweli.
It is 25 years. In fact, 16th of December we are supposed to be celebrating 25. Silver jubilee of our marriage.
Silver jubilee. Wow.
This girl has never told me atarudi kwao. Ajawai rudi kwao. In fact, the truth is this. Not even my mother or my brothers or her brothers or nobody has ever heard us that we have quarreled one day.
Hakuna mtu amewahi sikia kwamba tumegombana.
They have never heard.
Hawajawahi sikia.
They have never heard.
Hawajawahi sikia.
Ask our children. They are here.
Uliza watoto wetu.
Ask them whether we have ever fought.
Waulize kama tumewahi.
They will tell you the truth.
Watakwambia ukweli.
They have never seen us fight.
Hawajawahi tuona tukipigana.
That tells you we don't fight. In fact, we have never fought.
Hatujawahi pigana.
We agreed many years ago. An argument is not a quarrel.
Tuliyakubaliana miaka mingi imepita.
If we don't agree on something,
kama hatukubaliani kwa jambo,
we postpone it.
Tunalitenga.
We tackle it when we are sober.
Tunalishughulikia
tukiwa. But we don't allow any disagreement to generate into a quarrel or a flaring anger. Unaiachia hapo. Twende tulale. Tena. Don't allow your bed to be the place ya kesi mahakama mkuu inakuwa kwa kitanda. Mkiingia kitanda, kumbuka vile ulifanya mwaka uliopita. Mnaongea mpaka saa 10 usiku na mzee anarudi anaingia job asubuhi. Kitanda yenu sio mahakama kuu. It's not the Supreme Court. Don't take mutunga to your bed. Ati ni kazi yake kusikizaga kesi zenyu usiku wa manane. Hapana. It's not good. That's a place to rest. Mumechoka, you need rest. Mnanielewa? Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Wangapi mko hapa?
Tuko hapa.
Bwana asifiwe. If God has blessed my marriage.
Kama Mungu amebariki ndoa yangu.
You can tap into that same grace.
Kutoka kwa hiyo neema.
For your own marriage, for your own children, for your own husband.
Watoto wenu, mume wako.
I'm telling you.
Nakwambia.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Don't desire, I wish Pastor Gikwa was my husband. Oh. I cannot be your husband. Only tap into the grace God has given me as a good husband, and your husband will become a good husband. Yes. Don't desire me to be your husband. If my wife is a good wife, don't say, I wish mom was my wife. All you can do is you can tap into the grace God has given her. And you can be
yako iwe sawa.
You can also do good.
Na kwako kuwe sawa.
Unagundua mahali. If God has blessed our children.
Kama Mungu amebariki watoto wetu.
We are in the campuses.
Wako
kapa. Kako wapi mso? Haka. Haka diko karasi boni ketu. Kuja hapa. Kibia. Kibia hapa. Jeff. Haka toto kaende praise him. Kalikuwa ka praise him kakiwa katoto. Staki kapoteze hiyo mwenini. Hiyo shauku. Nona saa vile kamerefuka. This is our last born girl. Bwana asifiwe. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Na nyinyi vijana mtume mko hapa msichezee huyu msichana. Wewe! Nikiwaona karibu na kwangu nitaachilia upo. Tuko na upo mmoja inaitwa Popi.
Popi.
Na paka tatu. Paka tatu moja inaitwa Nice. Hizo paka zitakukimbiza. Kwa sababu gani? Kwa sababu you don't come to do that way. You tap into the grace.
Unachota kutoka kwa neema.
Lakini si kunyemelea.
Sio kunyemelea.
Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Respect our home.
Heshimu nyumba ya mchungaji.
Yes. Yeah. In Jesus name.
Katika jina la Yesu.
Amen. Sioni pa. Kama nisipotetea huyu msichana, na mnafikiria nani hapa atamtetea?
Nani atamtetea?
Unaona? Unafikiria ni kasichana kakapita kipita njia. Huyu kipita njia.
Na dadi na mamu.
Hako na dadi na mamu. Asili ya paka. Asante. God bless you. Wapigieni makofi. Bwana asifiwe. Thank you so very much. Amen. What am I saying?
Nasemaji.
If you see Pastor Gikwa driving a new car, tap into that grace within the next 2-3 weeks utajikuta na wewe umeingia kwa hiyo roho kwa sababu gani hivyo ndivyo inafanyaga ka
yes
tell your neighbor tap into the grace
tap into the grace
tell somebody shake them mwambie tap into the grace
tap
mwambie tap into the grace
tap
mwambie tap into the grace
tap into the grace
mwambie tap into the grace
tap into the grace
in Jesus mighty name
amen
how many are with me if God gives me a new house in Nairobi
Mungu akinipatia nyumba mpya
those of you who are tenants on your marks your time to be tenants is over you will need to rise them first and own your own houses why
Jesus mighty name
you got to tap into the
yes maweza kuchota kutoka kwa hiyo neema
haraka sana
haraka
maana hiyo ni neema imeachiliwa kwa wakati huo haikuji kwa mtu mmoja inakuja kwetu
pamoja
ah hapo mwanza kwetu inatembea mwambie inatembea kwetu zote
inatembea kwetu
mwambie hiyo neema
neema
inatembea
kwetu zote
bwana asifiwe
amen
wangapi mko hapa bwana asifiwe
haleluya
my son is graduating on the 25th of this month
Manasi ana graduate tarehe 25 mwezi huu.
Tarehe 27.
Tarehe 27.
Hiyo 25th hatuja musiende Gikwa.
Musiende.
Because 27 tutakuwa hapa.
Hapa.
Tutawaandalia lunch ya ku celebrate.
Yes.
With us. You are our family.
Yes.
Amen.
Thank you.
Nyinyi ndio familia ya?
Yetu.
Amen. Kwa hivyo wale wengine walio familia yangu, ndugu zangu, mama yangu na wao wakuja wapi?
Hapa.
Maana nyinyi ndio familia yangu. Hapa. Hapa.
Amen.
Hapa watakuja hapa. So what will happen is this. That 27th day we shall have service and then we shall have lunch together. All of us.
Tutapata ibada na tupate chakula pamoja
tena. As we thank God.
Tunaposhukuru Mungu.
Because we have a child who has been brought in the house of God and that is his graduating. His graduation is supposed to be our graduation and by the time he is doing that you better prepare because your own children are also going to graduate.
Watoto wako pia watagraduate anapofanya hivyo jiandae pia.
Tell your neighbor you are the next online.
You are the next online.
Tell somebody your children are the next online.
Your children are next online.
Amen.
Amen.
How many are with me? Bwana asifiwe. Lastly, this is the last thing I will say.
Yera mwisho.
Last week we were in Bishop Kanyaru's church. Anytime we go to that church, Bishop Kanyaru will receive me as a father.
Askof Kanyaru tunampokea kama baba.
He came looking for me in a press code key number 1995. Alisikia kuna kanisa linafanya milipuko. Akasikia akiwa Murang'a walikuwa inajulikana Kenya hii. Kuna mahali kunaitwa Kinama inasemekana kuna mambo yasiyo ya kawaida inafanyika huko. Akatoka akaja mpaka ukasema nimekuja maana nimesikia sifa ati kuna kanisa linakuaga huko. I wanted to meet you. Hadi kunikuta mimi nilikuwa nimeenda kununua spare gavjaga. KWT alikuta mama akamnunulia nyama choma na ugali wakakula. Tangu siku hiyo tukawa marafiki. Bwana asifiwe. Every time I go to the church in Murang'a, it's one of the our old churches in Kenya. It has about 40 something years tangu wajenge kanisa pale. Bishop Kanyaru has been a father to over 100 churches all over. And so we receive him as a father and I know the grace of God in him. One of the graces that is in Bishop Kanyaru is the grace of prayer.
Moja hapa ya neema
ni mzee wa maombi.
Mzee wa maombi.
And I like tapping to that grace of prayer.
Ninapenda hiyo neema ya maombi.
Na ninaitoa kwake.
Mhm.
Amen.
Amen.
Two, he is a man of order.
Ni mtu wa mpango.
You don't see disorder in his church.
Haupati kutokuwa na mpango kanisani lake.
And I tap into that grace.
Ninapokea hiyo neema.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Anytime I go there, God would speak to me to do something.
Ninapoenda pale Mungu ananinenea nifanye jambo.
Bwana asifiwe.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe.
To tap and connect with that grace.
Kuweza kuunganika
na hiyo. There is a time we went there.
Kuna wakati
and God spoke, we saw for there were seats like this, the plastic.
Kulikuwa na viti kama hivi.
And God laid in my heart, our heart, to buy a seat for him, special seat for the bishop and his wife.
Tununue kiti speciali cha askofu na
wife. We called the key leaders in Atorambia, Mungu anasema you buy a seat for the bishop. Wakatwambia hiyo count it done. 1 year later hakuna kitu ilikuwa imefanywa. And then it's then God spoke akasema hii haikuwa yao, it is you. Ni hii niliwaambia. Tulitoka Murang'a, I don't know whether it was on a Thursday. Tukaja tukasunguka huko Nairobi tukatafuta viti ambazo fa askofu special seat by the grace of God we got two good seats zuri sana one of them was going I think for how much I don't remember it was either 27,000 or 37 either there so we bought two they costed us over 60,000 viti mbili tukaziweka kwa gari mpaka Murang'a. Kaambia imam kaa hapa, dadi kaa hapa. Hata hizo picha tuko nazo kama zinayakuwa, we don't have the time. Wakasema they have never seen anything like that. Bwana asifiwe. Let me tell you, the seat signify authority. They have been there. Wako na kanisa la zaidi watu 1000. Nobody had ever seen that their bishop require a special seat in the church. And we told them it's why ikaliwa na mtu. Ibada ikiisha inatolewa inawekwa ofisi. Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Shortly after that, God touched somebody here to buy us these seats. Hizi seats zilinunuliwa na dada moja kwa hapa kwa hii church. Hizi mnaonaga hapa.
Amen.
Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Why? We had tapped into the grace that is in Bishop Kaniaru. Bwana asifiwe. Not only that, she went at one given time, she saw his house, there was no dining table, she bought a very good dining table for them. We have put carpets in their altar. Tukiwa hapa tu, nyinyi mnacheza. Last week we went, tukakuta Bishop hako US, lakini kwa ofisi yake kulikuwa na shati, kulikuwa na nini, na hanga imewekwa shati na matai zake. Kwa ofisi tu mahali kama pale. Tukaangalia tukasema hapana, why don't we make a wardrobe? Hizi nguo badala ziwekwe pale kwa ofisi ya askofu, ziwekwe vizuri. Tukaita fundi haraka sana. Kasema tuwaitie fundi mzuri hapa, mnajua tukaitiwa fundi mzuri. Kamwambia this is what we want. We want you to make a good wardrobe, muweke pale chini mahali ya kuweka viatu nini nini. How much is that going to cost? Tukahesabu akasema 10,000. Nzuri sana. A very good one. And then within 3 days it was ready. We went there on Tuesday, and by the time we left there on Sunday, already there was a good wardrobe. Na nguo za askofu zimewekwa ndani ya ile wardrobe. Sasa alipokuja, because he came back on this week, the other night, I don't know, last night, it is the first time nimeenda kwa ofisi, and I am shocked by what I am seeing in the office. I'm shocked by what I am seeing in the office. Hiyo ni ofisi yake pale Murang'a. Ako na kwa wengi, lakini hawaoni nafasi ya kujiunganisha na neema yenye Mungu ameweka kwa askofu. Wow. Lakini mtu anaenda pale anaangalia, anaona hapa pana nafasi ya kujishikanisha na nini? Na neema yenye iko ndani ya mtumishi wa Mungu. Bwana asifiwe. Sasa nyinyi mnaonaga watu wamebarikiwa mnashindwa. Mimi naambia watu baraka hazikujagi. Baraka ni kutafutwa, zinatafutagwa. Ambia mwenzako baraka ni kutafutwa, zinatafutagwa.
Baraka ni kutafutwa.
Mwambie baraka hazikujagi.
Baraka hazikujagi.
Mwambie baraka zinatafutagwa.
Baraka zinatafutwa.
Pigia Yesu makofi kama unanielewa kile ninachosema. Bwana asifiwe sana. Wengine wetu tumekaa tu pale kung'ang'ana. May your struggles be over from today in Jesus mighty name.
Amen.
May you tap into the grace that yes. God has given his servants.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
And that's what I preach what I read.
Na ubiri kile nachofanya.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't come here to give you stories.
Sikuja hapa kuapa historia.
I told the people of Murang'a.
Nikaambia
now bishop is, I read them Philippians 4 verse 15. You Philippians know, mulikuwa munanitumia. And I told the people, bring your sacrifices. We are going to collect an offering. We are going to have it wired to the US. And tell him, we are standing with the word in Philippians 4:15. People brought money. And they were able to raise, I think within the service, 50,000. We raised 50,000. It was about 40 something, 45. I told the pastor that let's add it. We need 50,000. At least. Amen. Bwana asifiwe. Why? Why?
Kwanini?
Because I needed to see God blessing the people through being practical in business.
Akibariki watu kwa kufanya mambo yanayoeleweka.
Everybody lift up and say, my father, my father,
my father, my father,
as I come to the end,
as I come to the end
of the month of October,
of the month of October,
may you teach me,
may you teach me,
may you help me,
may you help me
to tap
into the grace
that is in your servants,
that is in your servants,
that is in my prophets,
that is in my prophets,
in
Jesus' name.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Everybody stand up. Lift up your hands to the Lord. Just tell the Lord, thank you. Thank you, Father, for speaking to us today. Thank you for the entrance of your word. May you teach us to tap into the grace. May you release your grace working us. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for the abundance of your grace. Thank you for the abundance of your grace. Thank you for the abundance of your grace, my Father, that you are releasing in our lives.
life. That you are releasing in our 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 life. May you teach us, oh God, to connect with the grace. To connect with the grace. To connect with the grace.
How to connect?
Teach us to connect with the grace. Teach us to connect with the grace. Force us to walk in the grace. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that our children and our children after us shall be great as a result of understanding the power of connecting with the grace the Lord is giving our life.
Jesus' mighty name.
Glory be to God.
Glory to God.
Lord, we thank you.
We thank you, Lord.
Thank you for your grace.
Yes.
That brings salvation. Mm. Thank you for the grace that is in Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Thank you for the grace
yes.
that is in your servants,
yes.
our prophets,
yes.
and all these levels of grace
oh, yes.
that you have given us, O God.
Hallelujah.
May you cause us to operate in them.
Yes,
none of us shall miss your grace.
Yes.
None of us shall miss the grace.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
We bless you. We honor you. Now, the four levels of grace. One, the grace that brings salvation.
Amen.
Two, to every one of us is given a measure of grace according to your gift. Three, connecting with the grace that is in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
And four, connecting with the grace that is in your prophets. You get that?
Yes.
Bwana asifiwe.
Amen.
Now, I want you to get an offering. Connect with the grace in this word.
Yes.
Connect with the grace in this word.
Na neema iliyo katika hili neno.
By your offering.
Kupitia sadaka yako.
And I want to teach you.
Ningependa nikufundishe.
And you know by now.
Na unajua kwa sasa.
Learn to connect with the altar when the word of God comes to you.
Jifundishe
so that you make the best. We are talking of tapping. Tell your neighbor tapping.
Tapping.
Tell your neighbor tapping.
Tapping.
Tell your neighbor tapping.
Tapping.
You
tap into that.
Unachota. Unachota mtiririko. Mtiririko wa neema.
You flow. You tap into it.
Unachota kutoka kwa mtiririko wa neema.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
You tap.
Unachota.
You tap.
Unachota.
That is how people's life change.
Hivyo ndivyo maisha ya watu inabadilika.
And you remain there wondering what is going on. I declare none of any one of you in this church shall be a wanderer. Everyone shall be a partaker. None of you shall be a wanderer. Everyone is a partaker of the blessings of this altar. Every one of you shall be a partaker of the blessings of this altar. In the name of Jesus Christ. And as you connect with this word, receive the new level of grace. Receive a new level of grace. Receive the new level of grace. Receive the new level of grace. Receive the new level of grace. Receive a higher level of grace. May the grace of God work for you in your situation, in your marriage, in your business, in your career, in the life of your children, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. May you connect with the new level of grace, 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 the new level of grace. Walk in the new level of grace that the Lord has for you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. May you manifest, may the new level of grace manifest for you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, may you see the new level of grace, taking you places you never thought, doing things you never thought they were possible, for your life, for your family, in your health, in your business, in the life of your children. May you receive a higher level, a higher level, a higher level, a higher level of the manifestations of God. In Jesus' mighty name. Somebody say, I receive a higher level of grace.
A higher level of
upon my life.
Upon my life.
Upon my family.
Upon my family.
Somebody say, I tap.
I tap.
I tap.
I tap.
I connect.
I connect.
I connect.
I connect.
I connect.
I connect
with a higher level.
With a higher level
of grace.
Of grace.
For myself.
For myself.
For my children.
For my children.
For my family.
For my family.
For my marriage.
For my marriage.
For my career.
For my career.
For my business.
For my business.
For my ministry.
For my ministry.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive it now.
Receive it now.
I declare new levels.
New levels.
New accomplishments.
New accomplishments.
New manifestations.
New manifestations.
Greater level.
Greater level.
In the work of my hands.
In the work of my
finances. Finances.
Finances. Finances.
I receive the grace.
I receive
to tap into you.
Tap into you.
I receive.
I receive
the grace.
the grace
of riches,
of riches
that is in Christ.
That is in
Christ.
I receive
the grace of life,
the grace of life
that is in my prophet,
that is in my
prophet. In Jesus' name,
in Jesus.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Why don't you worship the Lord with a clap of hands today?
Hallelujah.
Worship him in the clap of hands today.
Are you here? You are not saved. That's the last thing I was saying. It is begins the grace of God that brings
salvation
have appeared to all men. If you are here, you are not saved. Today you can tap into the grace of salvation by saying, yes, Jesus save me.
Kwa kusema ndio, Yesu niokoe.
Lift up your hand if you are there, you are not saved.
Kama uko pale hujaokoka, inua mkono.
And do it very fast.
Na ufanya hivyo kwa haraka.
I want to pray for you to be saved.
Nipenda nikuombe uokoke.
After you now receive the grace of salvation,
baada ya kupokea neema ya wokovu,
all these other graces will work for you.
Neema hizi zingine zote zitatenda kazi kwako.
Before you receive the grace of salvation,
kabla
these others can't.
Hujaokupokea neema ya wokovu, hizi zingine haziwezi tenda kazi.
So it starts at salvation.
Inaanza kwa wokovu.
Are you here? You're not saved? Lift up your hand.
Kama uko hapa hujaokoka, inua mkono.
And I want to pray for you.
Nikuombe
that Jesus will come in your heart.
Baba Yesu ataingia moyoni mwako.
To be your Lord and your Savior.
Akuwe Bwana na Mwokozi.
Anyone like that? You are there, you're not saved. Lift up your hand.
Aliye hivyo ambaye hajaokoka, inua mkono.
I'll pray for you.
Nimuombe
to be saved.
Uokoke.
Are you there?
Uko pale.
Okay, everybody lift up your hand.
Kila mtu inua mkono.
Father, I release the grace.
Baba ninaachilia neema.
Of salvation
ya wokovu
to the family members of this dear people,
watu wa jamii ya hawa,
our husbands,
mama,
homes who are not saved,
ambao hawajaokoka,
our children who are not saved,
watoto wetu ambao hawajaokoka,
our friends,
marafiki zetu,
we release the grace of salvation.
Tunaachilia neema ya wokovu.
This week let there be a week of salvation.
Wiki hii ikawe wiki ya wokovu.
And somebody here will give a testimony,
na mtu hapa atatoa
ushuhuda, that their husbands got saved,
kwamba mumewe aliokoka,
their wives got saved,
mkewe aliokoka,
their children got saved,
watoto wao waliokoka,
their parents God saved.
Wazazi wake,
because we now release the grace of salvation.
Manake sasa tuachilia neema ya wokovu.
We also pray,
pia tuomba,
that you, everyone in this church,
kwamba kila mmoja katika kanisa hili,
they will receive the grace for the gifts you have given them.
Tupokee neema ya vipawa ambavyo,
in our work, in our business, in our marriages,
zetu, ndoa zetu na katika kazi.
Release the grace,
achilia neema,
according to the gift,
kulingana na vipawa.
I also pray,
pia naomba,
everyone of us shall tap into the grace of riches that are in Christ.
Kea kutoka kwa neema ya utajiri.
We shall continue to tap,
na tutaendelea kuchota,
into the grace that is in our prophets,
kwa neema iliyo ndani ya nabii wetu,
and let it change our life,
na wacha ibadilishe
maisha, let it change our testimony,
ibadilishe,
let it open doors for us,
ifungue milango,
let it make us live a life of miracles,
fanye tuishi maisha ya miujiza,
sign and wonders,
ishara na maajabu,
and in it, oh Father,
katika yote Baba,
be glorified and exalted,
tukuzwe na uinuliwe,
because we ask in Jesus' name,
tunauliza katika jina,
amen and amen. Receive the grace for healing.
Amen.
The grace of healing that is in Jesus, receive it.
Amen.
The grace of new opportunities that is in Jesus, receive it today.
Amen.
The grace of open doors for you that is in Jesus, receive it.
Amen.
And the grace that God have released in my life and in the life of my family, may it work for you.
Amen.
I say may it work for you.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Celebrate the Lord with a clap offering today, and may this message change your life. Amen and amen. How many believe that's a good message for you?
Okay. Thank you.